The area of the curved surface of a cylinder is 1320 centimeters square. The height of the cylinder is 10 centimeters. What is the radius of the cylinder in centimeters? What is the radius of the cylinder in centimeters? Now we have our cylinder. This. Okay. This is our cylinder. Okay. And then we have the area. We have the area of the curved surface and the height. Okay. So our height is 10 centimeters and area of the curved surface is 1320 centimeters square. Okay, so the area of the curved surface, which is the curved surface? Okay, the curved surface is our cylinder. When we cut it here, okay, let's say we cut the cylinder. If we cut it and open it up, okay, if we cut our cylinder here and open it up or stretch it like this, it is going to be something like this. See, the curved surface, okay, of the cylinder, if we cut here and stretch it up, it is going to give us something like this. So this is some kind of a rectangle, okay? And we are told that the area of the curved surface, which when we cut and stretch it is going to be like this, is 1320. It's equal to 1320. Now, this side, we have it already, which is height. Okay, we are given the height here. See, height and 10 centimeters. So our height and 10 centimeters. This is the height. Okay, you know when you find area of a rectangle, how do we get it? Area of a rectangle is given by length times width. Okay, it is given by the length multiplied by the width. Okay, so here in our question or in this shape, the cylinder, the length, which is this one here, okay, from here up to here, is this distance round the circle. Distance round the circle. The distance from here up to here is the same distance round this circle here. Because we have just opened up the cylinder and stretched it. So nothing is going to change. The distance round the circle, when stretched, will give us the length. Okay? And the height is the one which is going to give us the width. But now, how do we get distance round a circle? Distance round a circle is known as circumference. Okay? So, distance all round this circle is the same distance from here to here, is known as circumference. Okay? So, circumference. Distance round the circle is known as circumference. And how do we get circumference of a circle? C is equal to 2 times pi times radius, 2 pi r. Okay, distance round a circle is known as circumference, and circumference is 2 times pi times radius. Okay, so all it means is that from here up to here, the distance is 2 times pi times radius. Because from here up to here is the same distance round the circle, and a distance round the circle is circumference, and circumference is 2 times pi times r. And now our width is the height of the ceiling. That is why when we want to get area of the curved surface of a cylinder, we say area is equal to, okay, the length. Length is 2 times pi times r, 2 times pi times radius, multiplied by the width which is the height in this case here, which is h, multiplied by h. This is how we get curved surface area, okay, of a cylinder. So, area, okay, is equal to 2 times pi times radius times height. See how we got this formula from using this rectangle? This is the width, which is the height, and this is the distance, which is the distance around the circle, which is 2 times pi times radius. Okay, so now, area is equal to 2 times pi times radius times height. But the question has already given us the area, and the area is 1320. The area, okay, of the curved surface is 1320. So we have the area. We know the pi, because pi, the question is telling us to use pi as 22 over 7. We don't know the radius, and that is what we're looking for. We know the height, because the height is 10 centimeters. So what you need is just to substitute. See, now area is equal to 2 times pi times radius times height, which equals to 1320, is equal to 2 times 22 over 7 times r times height is 10 centimeters. Okay, so now 2 times 22 is 44. 44 times 10 is 440. So we have 1320 is equal to 440 over 7 times r is 440 over 7 r. But now we're looking for what? We're looking for r. So what we do is we want to get rid of the 440 over 7 on this side, so that r can remain alone. Okay, so what we do is, if you want to get rid of 440 over 7, we multiply by its reciprocal, which is 7 over 40. And why? So that we can easily cancel by 7 once, by 7 once, by 440 once, by 440 once. See, it is gone. Now we are remaining with r only. This side, because we have an equal side, whatever you do on this side, you need to do the same thing on this side. Okay, so we're going to multiply by 7 over 440 as well on this side. Okay, so we can start with the 0. By 0, 0 gone, 0 gone. And then by 2, 22. By 2 is 66. See, you can see that you can easily, because here 66, here 22, we can cancel by 11. By 11, 2 times. By 11, 6 times. And then by 2 once, by 2, 3. And 3 times 7 is 21. So, is equal to 21. So, our r, here, remember, we have our r, okay, is equal to 21. Our r is equal to 21 centimeters, which is